So in today's video, you'll learn these 10 unconventional ways on how to integrate videos into your marketing and marketing campaigns. Let's take it to the next level. So there's so many ways to leverage video into marketing and marketing campaigns, some that have so much potential, but a lot that many businesses don't even use. So many of the videos I'm going to show you today I've successfully implemented in the past, but some of the other ones I've just seen other businesses use, and it's just really interesting to see how they've implemented it. So the first video is in recruiting, and there's so many different things and questions that people want to know if they're planning to apply for a position with that organization or maybe want to work there down the road. Things like, what is it like to work there? Their pay, what the culture is, you know, how to even prep for an interview. So why not create videos answering all these questions? A great example is Refund Labs, who's created a site using video to answer all the questions that a potential applicant or candidate might have. Then you can send the site or the different questions to candidates. That way you don't have to keep answering them over and over again. So the second type of video would be internal communications. And many employees want to know what's going on across an organization. And sometimes it's tough to know that in your specific department. For example, at Brookfield Residential, I'd be working at the corporate office, but there's a lot of different things that are happening on site, whether it's in our communities, our different homes, that would really help me do my job. And also I know it would help other people in other divisions do theirs. To solve this problem, we actually created a monthly video series featuring our chief operating officer. And he would do a vlog highlighting key events, progress on communities and developments, highlight key employee initiatives, and just really what's happening around the office. It was really well received because it was coming from a different, you know, a really authentic side where he would just take a camera and just walk around the office, impromptu interviews with employees, and just have those, you know, authentic conversations that you don't normally get with a scripted video. And it's something that's really awkward that employees can see right through. So the third type of video would be with customer experience. Now, have you ever bought a product or, you know, signed up for a service and you ask yourself, okay, what do I do now? Well, how about create videos or a series of videos answering all the questions or potential questions that a new customer will have? Next, Steve has a great YouTube video series explaining how their product and service actually works.
To answer a call on your Panasonic HDV 230 phone, either pick up the handset or...
But you don't have to use it just for product video. You can create welcome videos or even an orientation series. And they don't even have to be that long. You can leverage Instagram's Reels or TikTok to create a bunch of short videos. That way it's really easily consumable. So the fourth type of video would be for sales. Now, if you ask any sales team member, they probably answer the exact same question over and over and over again. So why not create a series of videos answering those questions that your sales team members can send to prospects? They don't have to answer the questions and they can get into the details and more advanced questions that a potential prospect would have. So at Benevity, I created a series of micro videos. I actually leveraged Wistia and created a Wistia channel where it answers all the most common questions that a potential prospect would have about corporate giving or workplace giving software. And these clips were just taken off of the YouTube video series that we were filming. So these videos answer all the questions pre-purchase, during the purchase process, and post-purchase. And all the other sales team members have access to this channel that they can send to their prospects as well. So the next type of video is for content. And do you ever ask yourself, do I really want to watch this video, listen to this audio file, read this blog post, or even download this gated piece of content? And a preview video will allow the consumer, whether they watch, listen, or read, you know, the benefits of actually consuming that piece of content. So one of my favorite techniques is to create a preview video and put it on a landing page. And whether it's a gated, you know, PDF or gated video or whatever it is, it usually increases conversion rate by 15 to 20% by previewing what that person will actually get and what are the benefits of consuming that content. And Andy Crestedina actually does a really great preview video for a lot of his blog posts and gives it more of a hook of what are the benefits of reading the entire post. So the sixth type of video is a setup video. And I really like using this as a marketing tactic, kind of building a small little mini video funnel where I create two videos and piggyback on a latest trend, event, or situation. So you create a value-based or explainer type video of the trend or situation. Then you retarget all those people who watch anywhere between 50 to 75% of that explainer video and create a second more product focused sales focused video, still piggybacking on that trend. So an example of this is leveraging, you know, what we created at Homebuyer School. So the government of Canada, you know, released this first-time homebuyers incentive. So we created a video explaining what the benefits were and how first-time homebuyers can take advantage of this new first-time homebuyers incentive. Then all the people who watched that video, you know, anywhere between 50 to 75%, we retargeted with another video, now leveraging Brookfield's new program that, you know, hooks on to that first-time homebuyers incentive. So we already know that all the people who watched 50 to 75% of our first video, our explainer video, is definitely interested. And then we just know that because they're warmed up, that we can now, they can now take advantage of Brookfield's new program. So the next type of video is related to teaching your audience. And this should be a no-brainer, but there's so many businesses that still don't use this. And if you've heard me in the past, the easiest way to start is, you know, take the top 50 questions that your prospects or clients are always asking and create videos answering those questions. So number 8 is videos related to events. Now, we usually send a contingent of people to trade shows or conferences, right? You've got people manning the booths, you got people attending the sessions, maybe people attending the keynotes. Well, this is actually a great opportunity to create thought leadership type videos and leverage all the people, either the people who are attending the conference or the trade show, as well as the key influencers there as well. The easiest way to do this is hire a videographer, or you can even do it on your phone, you know, get a gimbal or a selfie stick, and record one of your team members interviewing a micro influencer or a keynote speaker or somebody at that conference and ask them some of the top questions or pain points related to your industry. Another way is to book a hotel room and invite all those keynote speakers, you know, micro influencers, even prospects, and do maybe anywhere between a 20 to 60 minute interview with them. The amount of content that you can generate from 4 to 6 interviews will last you anywhere between 4 to 6 months, and you can reach more people through those micro videos through paid organic promotion than you could have reached or talked to at that conference. So the next type of video is point of view or behind the scenes. So what's it really like inside an organization? Who are the people behind the brand? You know, what are the processes like? How are products created? You know, these are a lot of the questions that a lot of people want to know when doing business with a brand, or just generally on what's it like inside. You can then send this to clients, prospects, investors, and they can have a more, you know, kind of that emotional, human connection with your company rather than the normal corporate speak or branded messages that they normally get. So the final type of video is user-generated content. And this is a great way to build engagement with your brand or business. And it doesn't have to be hard either. You can simply run a contest and, you know, pick the best video of people using your product or service. A fun way is to actually leverage TikTok and, you know, ask a question and use the stitch feature and have people, you know, create content based on your original question. So now you know 10 unconventional ways how to integrate video into your marketing and marketing campaigns. And if you want to know other strategies and tips on how to achieve your marketing business goals through video, hit the subscription button below, hit the little notification bell, and you won't miss anything. And if you want to learn other ways to leverage video in your marketing, you got to check out this playlist here. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.